Hey folks, welcome to the video. I want to share a Lightroom feature with you, which will totally level up your photography edits. I use this all the time in my professional photography, in my personal photography, and this is a feature that's kind of hidden in the interface of Lightroom that you may not have seen. If you have seen it, I'm going to show you how it's designed to be used and some other ways that you can use it that maybe you haven't thought of yet. Anyway, let's jump into Lightroom and take a look at what I'm talking about. So we're in Lightroom, and before I tell you what this tool is, let's just see if you already know about it. Can you see what's happening in these photos? So here, this is before, after, before, after, before, after, and before, after. This one should make it pretty obvious. This is the geometry correction tool. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna explain what it's for, and then I'll talk about how I use it, because I use it in basically everything. It's really powerful and it can really kind of level up your photo. So anyway, let's just go to the most extreme here. Look at this, this is the original photo. That's not even the original photo, that's the original photo. So that's straight out of camera, that's the raw file. We'll give it a little bit of an edit, we'll just reduce the highlights. That's basically all I need to do on this photo. This is Pamplona, this is just some buildings that I saw while I was there. Now, I can't straighten this image. If I want those buildings to look straight, I can't do that. And what that's because of is because when I shot the buildings, because I'm not a giant, I didn't shoot them straight on, I shot them tilting upwards, like that. I shot it tilting up, not straight on, because I'm, like I said, I'm not a giant. So to do that, you just go to geometry correction, go to guided. I'm just gonna grab a straight edge. Okay, so I'm gonna grab this straight edge there, and I'm also gonna grab this one here. So I just want two straight edges that are a little bit far apart. So now that's gonna totally pull the image to pieces. Now what I'm gonna do though, is I'm gonna tell it what I want to be straight. So I'm gonna take this one. Actually, no, I'm not gonna do that. That's the wrong one. Let's not do that. Let's pick one of these ones here. So something that's kind of obvious. So this here, I can see there's a straight line there. I want that to be straight. And then I'm gonna pick another one. What else do I want to be straight? This bottom one here, I want that to be straight. So now that image should be pretty straight. Obviously it looks warped as hell, but as soon as we crop in, actually what we've got is a nice sort of balanced image. That looks pretty good. Now, I could probably refine that a little bit more, but that's essentially what this is for. Now, you might say, well, that doesn't look natural, and you could be right. This is a creative choice when it comes to this sort of thing, but there are other sort of moments, and let's take this one, for example, so I'll just reset this. So what's happening here is I just shot this image from the hip. I was walking behind this person, and I just took a quick image, and what I've done is, instead of shooting straight on, I'm shooting slightly up. I'm just tilting the camera up a little bit, which means that it's kind of got this tapering effect where the top lines are not quite straight with the bottom lines, and no amount of straightening will change that. That's just the fact of the photo. Now you could use the vertical tilt that's in the kind of in the geometry area. So for example, we use vertical here. You know, you can change that, and that is a very quick way of doing it. And then if you've got constrained crop on, it will, you know, keep the image cropped, and that's probably fine. That won't take any twists out of the image. So for example, if I was shooting upwards like this and my camera is just slightly twisted, that will add elements to the image that cannot be taken out. The guided tool, so if you go guided again, so we're just going to grab this line here, grab that one, another straight one over here. We want to give it balance. So for example, this line here is pretty straight. So grab that one. So now that's straightened the thing there. I'm going to take this because I want that to be straight. You can see it's twisted. And then this bottom one here, we're very lucky because we've got this perfectly straight line that we're just going to use to do it. So there, now we've got a nice straight image. Again, regardless of whether you think it's natural or not, that's what this tool is for. Couple more photos. So here I've got my daughter with a camera, and that is the finished image, and the edit is here. So you can see it's not straight. I could straighten it. This one's actually a pretty good candidate for straightening, but again, it's not quite straight. You can see this, it's just twisted. So with when I took the photo, the camera just wasn't totally perfect with the plane of the wall, but not that really matters in this case. You know, if I just quickly up the whites on this picture, it's basically edited. That's fine, to be honest. But again, if you just wanted to geometry correct it, I would be picking this outer one here, one on the other side, probably this one. Then you need to pick one at the bottom and then another one. There's nothing at the top that I can use, so I'm going to use this one. So now it's nice and straight, and it doesn't matter where I crop it, it's always going to feel nice and straight. And it means I can kind of get a nice frame here, which is not centered, but I'm framing with the side bits just there. And then finally, another example really quick is, this is the original photo, and that is the edit. Now I think with this one, just actually editing the photo is kind of fine. It just doesn't matter that it's not straight, but again, if you wanted it to be straight, once again, you just go guided, grab one line, there's a nice line, grab another one, and then you need to make sure you've got the verticals in there as well. And this one. So now it's pulled the image super straight. So again, if we were cropping it, and this is kind of what you do if you knew you were going to be kind of printing the photo, or if it's going to a magazine or something like that, something that's got lines is going to be cropped. It makes it much more pleasing to the eye when you've got all these lines nice and straight. For example, like this, you can see that it's straight with all of the edges. And you can't really do that by rotating. You have to be kind of warping the image, and the geometry correction tool, particularly the guided, is super, super powerful. So those are some quick ways that you could use it on some more sort of casual photos. But how do I use it professionally? As you can imagine, exactly the same way. So for example, this is a shot of a cabin in the north of Scotland. This is it having been corrected, and that's it, just without. So it's still pretty straight. So what's key here is if I just show you how I'm guiding it. So for example, I've got the floor. I want the floor to be straight. I want these cupboards to be straight. I could have probably also chosen this line, and I know that this wants to be straight. I chose the window at the top because regardless of if the window is straight, I want it to look straight. These lines here, they might not be straight in relation to the rest of the thing. So I like to pick things that maybe they aren't straight, but they do want to look straight. From a construction point of view, you'd hope that your upright beams and your kitchen is straight. So that's why I've chosen those things. So that's how it's kind of designed to be used. And I use this all the time in my professional work when I'm shooting interiors and shooting spaces. I'm using that tool constantly, but it's not just about what it's designed to be used for. For example, if I just jump into some thumbnails, this is one of those cases where that's probably fine. And if I was to, you know, turn it 16:9 ready for a thumbnail, it looks pretty good. It looks pretty bang on, but you can see from the, you can see it's not quite right. It's just not quite perfect. So what I'm gonna do, you can just, it just doesn't feel right. Maybe if you're a beginner with photography, you might just be like, that's totally fine, but you can make it a little bit more perfect. And that's kind of where I'm coming from with this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna draw a box around it. Regardless of what's going on in the image, I'm just drawing a box around this camera like this. All those edges, I'm just gonna straighten like this. And then if you didn't get it quite right, you know, there is like this thing, this magnifier thing that you can see on the screen. I don't use that. I just do it by eye. You can see here, so I can do that. You can see the little cross that's coming up, just to kind of get it bang on. But I think it's a little bit distracting when you do it that way. But anyway, it means that now it looks, if you look at the little thumbnail down here, that's how I actually kind of monitor the thumbnails when I'm doing it. But you can see that it looks much better than, hold on. Now just look at that little thumbnail in the bottom as I go. This is corrected and this is off. It's very subtle, but that just is better. I did the same on this thumbnail here, for example. This is a bit different because it's a round object, but I'm not holding it flat. It's got nothing to do with the camera. It's more just how I'm holding it. This is a bit tricky because it's kind of dark there. So now I can take the top, and again, I'm just drawing a box around it. This is trickier because it's a round object, as I said, but there's no edit on this, but we can kind of get it somewhere near, can't we? Anyway, what I'm monitoring from is the little image in the bottom there. So let's just go 16:9 just to get it so it kind of looks about right. Now let's look at geometry on and geometry off. So it's very subtle, as I said, I'm looking at the image in the bottom left. It's very subtle, but that's corrected, that's not corrected. And you kind of can do that with rotation, but it doesn't correct all the geometry. It doesn't account for the twist in the lens. It only accounts for the leveling like this. So that's why geometry correction is super, super powerful. So there we go. Thanks for watching. I hope you found something in this video that you can experiment with, something that's going to enhance your photography edits. If you did, there's a couple of things you can do to help me out. One would be just leaving a like on the video. Another, just leave a comment below. But most importantly, enjoy your photography, and I'll see you in the next video.